Which one do you think is original? Many people teach how to distinguish an original charger from a counterfeit, but their explanations are often inaccurate. In this video, we'll explore where these counterfeit chargers come from and how to determine if a charger is a real or a copy. To make a proper comparison, we needed an original sample, so we went to the Apple store, but they didn't have the Hong Kong version, the one we needed. So we asked a friend in Hong Kong to buy one and send it to us. Now, it's time to get some counterfeit samples. This is the kind of market where you can find all sort of charger models at different prices. We spoke to several sellers looking for varying levels of quality and purchased the samples we wanted to review. In my opinion, the sellers in this market are experts at identifying originals and copies. I've learned a lot from them. For example, the number of pages in a notebook could be an important detail. If you are interested in knowing more about markets in China, please subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss the next video. Let's start with the packaging. Many sources say you can tell originals from copies based on the material, color, and labels on the carton. While there's some truth to that, the quality of counterfeit packaging can vary greatly. You can find copies with 2 RMB packages all the way up to 7 or 8 RMB packages that are nearly indiscoverable from the real thing. Even the serial number label can perfectly match the charger. One potential giveaway is the weight of the package. If there is a significant difference, it's likely a copy, but usually counterfeiters are careful about it and can easily control the package weight. Look at these 2 packages. One has a plastic hanger, the other is paper. This could make the situation a little bit complicated, as Apple used to make plastic versions, but now the new models have paper hangers, and also the design has been changed in some details. So, if you see a paper package, check that the design and seal match the newer style. Now, let's open this up and compare the chargers themselves.
As you know, Apple has been removing plastic parts from its product packaging for a few years now, in an effort to protect the environment. They are also looking at ways to reduce paper usage overall. Here you can see that the copycat chargers are modeled after the old versions of Apple chargers. The originals typically came with a 4 separated page manual and a 55-page notebook. Of course, there are also completely paper-based copycat packages, naturally with smaller notebooks imitating Apple's new packaging. Therefore, if you see a package with plastic parts that has fewer pages and a smaller notebook, that one is probably a copy too.
Some of the counterfeit might have misspellings or poor printing, but generally, they are nearly identical to the real thing. I think the best method is to check the charging spring. Even high-quality copies have subtle differences when placed next to the original. Based on what you've seen so far, would you be comfortable using a high-quality counterfeit charger, or do you insist on authentic original? Comment me down below. Now, let's take a look at the board.
Cracking open the case and getting to the board wasn't too tough for the low-quality sample. The board itself looked completely different, that much was clear. The high-quality sample was a bit trickier, but we managed to break the case ourselves without any fancy tools. The real deal, however, was a whole other story. It was like trying to break into a vault. The case was practically impenetrable. We needed some serious equipment to get in, so we found a place that could handle it for us. Even with the tools, it wasn't exactly a breeze, but eventually we cracked it open, and that's when we saw just how similar the high-quality samples board was to the original.